students, hope all of you are well. For today's lesson, I'm going to share with you techniques of writing a formal letter. This lesson will be done in a 3-series video. This is the first series, and in this series, I'm going to share with you only the formats of writing a formal letter. We are going to look at the format and how to lay out a formal letter. Besides, I'm also going to share with you the common errors done by students in regards to the formats. So, are you ready for today's lesson? In this video, I'm going to share with you the techniques of writing a formal letter. This is the first part of 3-video series, where in this video, I'm going to share with you the format of a form. Okay? The format is very important here because most of the time when students write formal letter, they missed out in the format part. Okay, they get the format wrong, or even when they get the format right, they write it wrongly. So first, I'm going to introduce to you the format. Then we are going to look at the common errors done by the students. Now, this is a blank template, and we are going to match this template with the format. Okay. Now, first, in a formal letter, the letterhead would be the sender's full name and address. You have to write your name and address first. Okay, and after that, you underline, then you put the recipient's name, position or address. Sometimes in your rubric, you won't have the name of a person. Probably you might only write a letter, you might be required to write a letter to the manager. So you don't have to create the name. You just say the manager. Okay, if there is a specific name, for example, Mr. Mohana, the manager of whatever corporation, then you write the recipient's name first. Alright, if no name given, then just ignore the name part. Now, where do you write the date? Okay, you write the date at the last line of the address. Exactly the same line. If you write here, this is your last line of the address. So this is where you write your date. Okay, so this is where you write your date. How your date should look like, you will see after this. After writing your date, then we move to the salutation. Dear sir, it's universal. If the rubric specifically says madam, somebody of a female, then you can say dear madam. Okay, now do you immediately jump to the introduction? No, in a formal letter, you need to have a subject heading. Okay, subject heading is the main picture, or you're giving a picture of what your letter is going to be about. Meaning to say, if I read your subject heading, I would know what you're going to write about. Okay, if you're writing a letter of complaint, so you say complaining about what? Okay, then your subject heading need to be underlined. Need to be underlined. Followed by the introduction. Introduction needs to be very brief. You don't have to have a lengthy introduction. Okay, this is a formal letter. So keep your language formal. After the introduction, you go to the content. Your introduction, you don't normally number it. But the body, you start with number 2, the second paragraph. Then your body can be as many paragraphs as you want, depends on how many points you're putting in one paragraph. I suggest you may put 2 points in one paragraph. Okay? So you can write up to 3 to 4 paragraphs. And the final paragraph, the last paragraph, will be your closure. Okay? Then once you're done with the closure, okay, say thank you. Then yours faithfully. Okay? Formal letter, please use yours faithfully. Then after that, you sign your name. You sign your name. After signing your name, the full name in capital letters. Okay, your full name in capital letters. And your designation. Okay, who are you? Where are you from? Okay, probably the residence of Taman Wat. Okay? Now, so this is a complete format. Now, all those students get the format right most of the time. There are some mistakes that make them lose marks. Format. Now let us see how to get the format right. Okay, so this is one example of the first part of a formal letter. Now you look at this format. What is the problem with the first part here? There is no capital for the name, there's no comma, and there's no full stop. So all these are wrong. This is how it's supposed to be written. The result name capital, comma. comma. Look how the address has been written. Capital, comma. Ecoland Park, comma. Eco, comma. Perak, full stop. Okay, then let us look at the next one. Liang Kok Development, wrong. Taman Perindustrian Rata, wrong. Kuala Lipis, wrong. All these needs to also be written in capital letter followed by comma. And at the end of it, you have to underline 65657, comma, Kuala Lipis, full stop, underline. Okay, remember all these small little details, yeah? Then the date, 15 July. Okay, July is a Bahasa Malaysia spelling, so that is wrong. Year, you can try to use the current year. So this is how you write the date. 15 July, J-U-L-Y, capital letters, 2020, full stop. Don't put TH here, 15 TH, no. K is wrong, you don't use. Now, the next one. Yes, sir. You see the D here, small letter. Sir, small letter, change. Dear sir, comma. Okay, dear sir, comma. This is how you should write. Now, complain about the construction of a new shopping mall. So, what are the things? Okay, this is heading. You know this is a letter of complaint. So, you see the heading is clear. You know what the letter is going to be about. Okay, the people are going to complain about some construction. But, why is it wrong here? Okay, there's no proper use of capital here. It is supposed to be complain about the construction of a new shopping mall. Okay, you see the article. Okay, the article and the about, the of are all in small letters. Complain, construction, new shopping mall is in capital. So remember where to put your capital, where to put the small letter. So this is the introduction. These are the errors that I often find when students write formal letters. Okay, we hope that you would consider our request to not build this shopping mall. This is because it will be more detrimental to us, than beneficial. Thank you for your kind attention. Full stop. Your faithfully, comma, blah blah blah. Now, what is the error here at the format part? The ending is perfect. The ending is perfect. But what is the problem with the ending? Your faithfully. Often students say your faithfully with capital Y and capital F. You don't put a capital F. Yours faithfully, capital Y, small f. Yours faithfully, comma. Okay, underline. Teresa Lim, wrong. Teresa Lim, capital, in block letters. And below Teresa Lim, you have to write her designation. What is she? For example, a resident of Taman Wangi. Okay, now, so this is about format. Hope you have understood the format of writing a formal letter well. And I also hope that in future, when you write a formal letter, you can remember the format that I have taught you and you will write a format error-free essay. So with that, I thank you and goodbye.